Hello everyone, StudiousToe here, back from the dead, coming to you from the magical land of post-commentary. The reason I am coming to you from post-commentary at the moment is, one, to tell you that for some reason something happened to the game audio in this recording, so there is no game sound. So I've added just some royalty-free YouTube music so that it's not quite as dull as just my voice. And also, I should probably apologize because I recorded this at about 2:30 in the morning. I started trying to make this video around 1 and had to fix a lot of things with my computer just because I haven't played or recorded much in the last few months. So the commentary may not be the best, but hopefully in upcoming videos, once I'm more rested and in a better mental state, this will all go fine. But anyways, thanks for watching, and I will return you back to regular live commentary. As you may have seen, depending on how editing went there, this game has some issues for me running, so hopefully we don't have too much of a problem with anything. So this is how we start our game. We start with this nice little plot of land. I believe this is supposed to be 1 kilometer squared, but don't quote me on that, unless you include the I believe and the unsureness of my voice. So we're basically just supposed to start off by building a road off of our freeway. This map I've chosen because I have not played it yet. And you always start off with outside access to a freeway. That's pretty much the only guarantee I think you have really for all of the maps. Some of them give you more, some of them give you less to work with than others. Eventually we will be able to expand into 9 squares. And you can mod it to get 25 squares of land. So there's quite a bit you can do in your city. And so we're just going to start off. You can see there are a bunch of road types and none of them are unlocked right now, but if we just build a road, we'll build this, then we unlock a bunch of stuff. We unlock the basics types of 3 different types of roads. We don't get highways for a little bit. We need a population of 5,000 to get the sound barrier highway and a population of 2,400. To get just the regular highway. So it's gonna be a little while before we get there, but this should go pretty quickly. I have several hundred hours in this game, more than probably I should admit, especially given how young this game is and how busy I have been. But we're just gonna start building this town. So I always make the mistake in my cities of not leaving enough space to convert this to a highway later. And that's kind of my general thought, is that your main road should eventually become your highway. Now, we don't have too much money to kind of plan out where all the roads will be and get too grand of a vision at this point. There is actually, you can screw up your city pretty badly if you spend too much time, like, kind of, if you spend too much of your resources early on planning out your city, getting a bunch of things too thought out and too permanent, because you can't collect taxes for a while. You unlock taxes with 440 people. So if you spend all of your money right at the beginning, you can screw yourself. Anyway, I'm just talking in circles right now. We are going to start building our city. So you see, we've got our roads here. This, like I say, will eventually be our highway, but first, I think over here, we're going to start off with something of a residential zone. And before we do that, actually, I'm going to, can we not check our resources? Okay, well, we can't. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm hopefully not too incoherent for you, dear viewer. But this area looks like we might be able to either have a foresting or farming initiative in this area later. We can't do that just yet. We haven't unlocked it. We'll get there soon. So actually, instead of building houses over here like I originally said, going back on my word, we're going to build some houses over here. So that should give us
enough space. Eventually, we're going to probably want an interchange not unlike this one in this area. So we're just going to give us a little bit of a grid. I like grids, even if they are pretty boring. And we're going to... I think we'll actually come in another layer here. Come in like that. And we will convert this to a two-way road. So you can see doing it this way. Oh, this is... Wait, did I do that right? One, two... I think I might have not done this right. Yeah, hold on. Sorry. So we're going to get rid of that. We're going to come out one full unit and then go back a little bit. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. And we're going to convert this to a two-lane road. You see two-lane and three-lane roads in each direction. So four and six, actually. They take up four blocks, the road itself, and one-lane each direction roads, they take up two. So we have to leave a little extra space for the road to come this way, but eventually this will probably be our main road. We're not going to spend money on that yet because we still have a few other higher priorities before we really get into that. First things first, we need to get water to our town and power. So you see, we can build either a water tower, which pumps water from the ground, which can be placed anywhere, or we can build a water pumping station, which we are going to choose. Now, a water pumping station has to be at a source of water, obviously, and you also have to drain your sewage into a source of water. So some maps, if you don't have it moving water, as you can see, as notated by these handy dandy little arrows, some maps, when there is no moving water, you have to use the water tower because you can't get your water from a place with sewage. I mean, you can, but that is one of the few ways you can guarantee your town will fail. So over here is going to be kind of our neighborhood. So we're just going to lay our pipe between first our water pumping station, our sewage station. Our pipes work both directions, by the way, both in and out with the water. And we're going to lay this, going to bring this over and kind of try and line it up with our grid over here. So now we have water pipes laid between. Now we need power. And so the early game, you have two options. You can either build a coal power plant or you can go with wind power. And I tend to prefer wind power, but I generally start with coal. I usually build one coal power plant and then switch to completely renewable energy after that. I'm thinking, though, based on this map, how we've started, it might not be too terrible to just start with wind power. Now, wind power per turbine, at least this type of turbine, only gives you up to 8 megawatts, whereas the coal power plant is a guaranteed 40. It is cheaper, especially at the beginning, to deal with coal. Your people will prefer clean energy, generally. We're going to go wind turbine. We're going to start wind turbine. I did that on my first map, on my first few playthroughs, first few maps that I've tried, starting with wind power, starting with renewable power. And you'll see on the ground, we've got, this shows us where our power travels. So you don't have to build power lines to everything, only things that aren't connected to each other. So you can see now anything we place within these power lines will have power, and anything within this blue area that we see around each of our powered things. So power can travel through streets, across the street to other buildings, from building to building that's adjacent, and in this case, like, it has a decent area where we can get the power from. So we're just going to connect this, I think, right about there. We'll probably have to adjust this at some point. And so now we have powered our water, our two water stations, which is pumping in and out. We have connected that to our power source, And we have that connected to what our first neighborhood is going to be. So let's start zoning. So we can zone all of this to be residential. It has to be on the side of the road. Hopefully I left enough. Did I leave? I think I left enough room for our future interchange. Whew. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and just let's zone this little section right here. We're going to zone all of that for houses, for low-density residential. And we're, this hill might prove problematic at some point. Without mods, you can't really do much in the way of altering the land. So we may have to get creative eventually. But for now, that's not to be worried about too much. I may actually move this in further now that I'm thinking about it, our main road. Okay, now you see, but we'll deal with that later. You see, that means they don't have power. We need to just extend our power line a little bit. It's good to come up a little short with the power line when you first lay it out and then figure out where it needs to be. Sometimes it's a little hard to predict, at least for me. And we still have, so down here you can see our demand for residential, for commercial, and for industrial or offices. So that shows us what the people want, what the city needs, and so we're just going to keep adding to our residential, like so. We can we'll have this be our main road. We'll have this be a main road for now. We'll extend this way in a few minutes. But for now, we're going to build some jobs over here. So we're going to come out three units about. That looks good. And then we're going to come out another four. Actually, yeah, let's do that. And this is going to be our main road. Now, we're actually going to leave space in the future for us to upgrade this. No, that's right. And this doesn't need to be a one-way road. That's a mistake. Okay, so we're going to leave, actually, space. Normally, I would prefer to make my grid very not leave this space here, but eventually, I'm going to want to upgrade this road to either a two- or three-lane road. So I'm going to leave space to do that so that we can maximize all our space later. But to save money, we're going to use a smaller road. Just because we don't want to waste money at the beginning. So, on our main road here, we're going to add, that's all going to be an industry, that's actually going to be way more than we need right now, but we have maximum demand, and we're going to start kind of planning the way, actually over here would be the best way, if we link our power this direction. We'll have to give these people water as well. So I think, it might work if we connect there. Yeah, there we go. We've got these people power. Now we need to get them water. Once we've got that done, we should be pretty good. We'll just, if it's parallel with our grid, that'll work. I think that's about. So they've got power, they've got water. And do they not have power? What happened to our power? I thought that was connected. You said you were, okay. So we're gonna just come out like that so we don't have to destroy any buildings to build power lines. And there we go. Now our industry section has power. We are up and running. Now the people, good people of our town, would like commercial. So we're going to extend our main road here. And actually, we're going to get rid of this at some point, that road. But we're going to extend our main road here. Come out another four. I tend to like grids 4x1. Kind of how I like to make them, if you can see. This, I would consider that one, which gives us lets us use all the space in between. And then four is a pretty good length for me. That's just kind of how I deal. Nothing sacred or just necessarily inherently optimal about that, I guess, is And so we're just going to go ahead and lay our pipes, and we're going to connect it back because you can have flow issues, you can have water pressure issues. And we're going to just lay all that in as low density commercial, and we're going to build houses. Now, there are mods that let you do basically what these houses automatically do with the terrain, that let you manipulate the terrain at will. I haven't used any of those, but I have seen other YouTubers use them to great effectiveness, truly. And I don't know why it's truly or so dramatic to say it that way, but you can do that. Roads will kind of, roads and buildings, they make do with what they have with the terrain. But other than that, you are pretty limited in terms of, you are held back by the terrain. And since our town is new, we have a lot of people wanting to move in. We're going to kind of let this be just our local retail area. You know what, we will, do we have enough space to build a full, yeah, there we go. Gonna build another little area here, like so. Connect our water pipes. And just fill all of this here in with houses. And I will admit that most of my cities end up being kind of boring because I like to be somewhat optimal laying a grid in this fashion. It lets you use most of the space. You can, of course, well, I don't know if of course is the right way to say that, but you can build curved roads like so. Has some really good tools. Okay, we've reached a population of 440. That is awesome. That means, first off, we can collect taxes. We get some money, and we also can get loans if we need them. And so we get a few new services: garbage, healthcare, and education. We can build an elementary school at this point. We can build a clinic. I don't know if we can build a cemetery just yet, but yeah, we can't build a cemetery. But we get to add a landfill, we get to add a school, and we get to add a medical clinic. So we're gonna speed our gameplay up now. And over here, kind of in our, in near our industrial zone, because these guys pollute quite a bit to begin with, we're going to build a, we might want to move it away a little bit, actually. We could even build over here, but that's going to be expensive. We're going to build a landfill, though. We're going to get a landfill area. First, though, we're going to deal with this. You see, these people don't have enough power. You can see our demand, our consumption is more than our supply, so we can just build another wind turbine here. Let's kind of find the optimal space. I want to be right at the edge of that 8, so that means we'll be getting, somewhere in there. We want to just, there we go. So that doubles our power generation, and that will help everybody else. Now we definitely need to build a landfill. So I'm thinking, I like having riverfront property. I like that to be houses. Just that's kind of my design. How I prefer to design. But the game doesn't always think that's the most valuable property. I think, okay, we don't want, we're gonna do this. Okay, we're gonna build. That will give us, we can upgrade this road in a moment. We're not gonna use this road just yet. We're just kind of laying out the grid. And then that will be more industrial. I'm just kind of planning ahead. This will be more industrial. And then after that, we're going to put landfills. Is that what I want? Okay, we're gonna use smaller roads for the landfills. So we're gonna leave one space. We're gonna eventually upgrade these two roads once we start using them. And we're gonna put a landfill kind of in this area. And let's see. Now, landfills, because of how they work, I'll just place one because we need one. They take up space a little differently than everything else because they are 8 by whatever. So we're going to come two units short of building a 2 width so that we can just fill this area with landfills. So you can see we'll be able to put another one right here. I don't know how coherent I am right now. I am tired and probably shouldn't be recording this, but hopefully that made sense. I'll just show. See, we'll be able to put another landfill here. We won't, actually. So that was kind of in vain because of the slope of the land. As I say, you are kind of at the mercy of your terrain. But no matter, we can build one here in a few minutes. But we're not going to build that yet. I am now going to build an elementary school. And actually, they just updated the game. They changed the design of the schools to a European style for European style maps. Actually, I haven't really gotten that much into what the different styles. Okay, so they just added European maps. We'll start with that. They added, there are different styles of maps. That's probably where I need to start. There are different styles of maps. Yeah, I probably shouldn't be recording. I'm a little too tired to be doing this, but no matter. So there are several different types of maps. Tropical and European are the two I can think of. There are other types. And so they each have different types of buildings. So for European maps, which is the style of map we are currently using, your school looks like this. Your houses kind of look like this. It's more distinct, at least to me. The distinctions are more noticeable once you get into high density, at least the base high density stuff. But I think we've got everything we need to do done before we resume playing. Okay, okay. So we've got demand for some industry, so we're gonna build, actually we're gonna build in here because we're gonna upgrade, when we upgrade this road, whatever is here is gonna be destroyed. So actually I should have thought ahead and done that over here as well. We're gonna lose these two factories. It's not actually that big a deal, but I just prefer not to. It's kind of a role-playing thing, I guess. I don't wanna build something or let the people build something and then destroy it immediately, especially if I know what I wanna build near it, if that makes any sense. When I edit this video, I'm probably going to wanna just start the whole playthrough over. And you can see these people are sick. And that's because we prioritized education over the health clinic, and that now we have enough money to build the health clinic. So that won't be an issue for long, but it is always, you always have to take into consideration that sort of decision. Now, how's our power look? Can we, yeah, okay. So this section of our power line is unneeded. So we can build our health clinic right here. And that should be a decent, how much does it cost to move it? Okay, it's gonna be a waste of money, but I'm gonna build it here because eventually, I just wasted $2,000 moving something to the exact same spot. I wish that wasn't possible. I'm going to take out a loan literally to move this to this. This is where we want it, like that position. Because we're gonna destroy this road sooner or later. And this is just going to be our main road to our city. Once we get highways, which is another, once we get to 2,400 citizens, this whole thing is going to be a highway. It's probably going to maybe curve through here like so, connect over here. Eventually, we're just going to be expanding as much as we can. But I'm just trying to keep an eye on the way the city is going. And we already need another turbine. So as you can see, wind turbines take a lot of management to keep up and running properly, which is the downside of using them early game. Other than that, we're doing pretty well. We've got our water. Water stays fine for quite some time. And we've got more demand for houses. So let's go ahead. We will fill in what we already have. And here. Now, I don't think I spoke about it why I left these gaps here, just so we can keep expanding our grid later, is why that is a thing. And we're gonna build on this side of the main road. And come out like that. just keep expanding our grid. And like so. And expand the water. Oh, and we have become a worthy village. Congratulations, son. So we can now we can buy a new area. We can buy a new piece of land. We can we have access to districts. We can choose what area our districts are. We have policies now. We can start assigning legislative policies to things. We can get a different loan. We can get a $60,000 loan instead of a $20,000. I know that technically this isn't a dollar, the currency, but we're just going to call them dollars. Industry specializations, we can choose what kind of industry we want to fill in an area, an industrial zone, and service policies. So we can adjust the existing services with the service policies. We also get a fire department, police department, unique buildings, forestry, specialization, agriculture. We get all of this stuff. The important thing, first off, is a fire department. Because once you get access to a fire department, then things just start burning down. And we're going to put it over in our industry, but we're going to put it along our main road. So hopefully that's... We're going to try not to put anything in this area because we want to interchange here later. Maybe not that big, but we're going to want to interchange here. So just trying to keep that in mind. I make that mistake a lot, kind of overcrowding. And then we have to either destroy or have very poor transportation. And we've got a healthy demand for everything right now. So we're going to build some more shopping. Then over here, we're going to come fill all of this in with houses, especially at the beginning, you expand pretty quickly. And we're going to build, okay, we're going to upgrade these roads to better serve our industry. I'll fix that power line in a second. And there we go. So that is probably way more industry than we need. And we're going to reconnect this power line. Okay, great. Is everything how we want it? We've got more houses, we've got more shopping, and we've got more industry. Okay, we've got everything we need. Now we're going to set some districts. So over here is going to just kind of be our generic industrial district. We'll clean this up as the city expands. And over here is just going to be our Empire Square. I like that name that it gives us. And we're also going to speed up the game. When you get to these checkpoints, which you get every so often, mine went blank. When you get to these checkpoints, the game goes back to regular speed. I prefer to always have it at the fastest speed possible. So you're always doing something. And as you can see, we still have a lot of demand for housing. We still have this up here. We're going to wait for that to be developed before zoning more area for housing. Oh, and we need to lay some more pipe. We're just going to kind of connect this like that. There we go. Trying to keep a good flow going. We'll just connect that. I'm sure there are more optimal ways to do all of that, but in the long run, it doesn't matter too terribly much. As long as everybody is being served. Ugh, I'm yawning, if you couldn't tell. And you can see we already need more power. So, especially early game, you can just kind of waste a lot of your map. Oh, do we not have a zone with 8? I don't want to be building 7 megawatts unless I have to. We can build on this side of the river, this little bit of land over here, maybe. And just connect it with power lines. Do that. Those are generating electricity, but it's not being put into our grid. And then, but now we could just connect it like that. Is that the shortest path? Yes, that's our shortest path. Just connect it like so. And we've got some power being generated over here. These are loud. People don't want to live near them, even if you disguise it as a park. You put a bunch of trees. I like the idea, actually. The idea of having wind turbines just kind of in the middle of a city, which I've done before. But people don't seem to like that because they're loud. As you can see, this is our noise pollution. This is loud. Our main road here is loud, and our shopping is loud. Our houses are quiet. It's kind of how all that works. Okay. So, we still have a lot of residential demands, and we're just going to keep expanding our little suburb here. Expand there and there and there. Do we have water everywhere we need it? No, we do not. So, you can get into a lot of, I think this sort of video, I've watched a few YouTubers play Cities Skylines, and I think this sort of game is best served when you're being creative, at least in videos. It's best if you're being creative with building your city. So, as you can see, you can get into a pattern of just doing the same thing over and over, especially early game, when you're just establishing the basis of your city. I like when you get into building highways and when you get to having subways, your metro system, and when you start getting into high density residential and trying to get all your land values high. That's the sort of thing I like to do. But I wanted to start at the beginning of the city instead of using a pre-existing city. But that's the part of the game I really love getting into. So we'll get to that soon enough. Hopefully with this city, assuming this video turns out well enough that I can post it. I have a feeling when I go to edit it, I'm going to be pretty embarrassed. But hopefully it's not too bad for you guys. I have been away quite a while from the YouTubes, which has been largely, like, we're going to upgrade this couple of roads here, largely because of school, and actually after I got out of school, there I only had a couple weeks really to hang out with a few friends before they got off onto their summer things. One's working at a summer camp, you know, we've got a couple who are working full-time jobs now, graduated from school or off into the real world, so had a very short window to spend with a few friends, kind of, I guess, for the last time, maybe, potentially. But all that's over, so I am here on YouTube for a little bit. I am also, I sort of have a job right now, could develop into more work, and so hopefully, I don't know, hopefully I have opportunities that YouTube isn't the only thing I'm doing this summer, but I have like half a job that could develop into more, and I'm looking for work this summer. Lots of stuff going on, so hopefully I can dedicate enough time to YouTube, at least over the summer. As I've mentioned elsewhere on this channel, I've kind of got a lot of stuff in my life right now in flux and up in the air, trying to figure out what I'm going to be doing in a few months, but hopefully it all works out. What I just did, I built a police station because I saw these little burglar masks that have disappeared. The cute little burglar masks, though, that indicate that we have high crime. Our fire risk, in my experience, where's fire? Can you not see it without? Fire risk, though, is very high right now, actually. Dramatically high, 68%. That is way higher than we want it to be. We're gonna build another fire station. Let's just build it here in town, here in the neighborhood. And that helped us a lot. You need a lot more in industry. As you can see, this basically shuts down. Oh, we need more power, don't we? Yeah. So we're gonna take out a loan, actually, just to get that power. We could wait a little bit. Let's find another. Oh, shoot. Our insatiable thirst for power. Oh, I don't know what I was talking about, and I think I really wanted to talk about it, whatever it was. Yeah, crime rates. Crime is a thing. That's what I'm saying. Go ahead and just keep expanding our grid for now. Grids work well. They use up... Oh, I meant to... Oh, well. That's the kind of thing I don't like doing. But grids work well. I kind of have my general philosophies. I'm kind of set in how I build my cities, which will be fine for this first set of videos, but I need to vary it up a little bit more, especially if I'm making videos of playing this game. So I'm complaining about something that I haven't done yet in the city. Well, I'm complaining about being boring, about repeating myself, because this game can get into that kind of pattern. Anyway, this has been a very scattered video. I don't know how much of it is usable, so I'm going to record a little more than I need, I think. As you can see, we're already starting to have some traffic problems. And so we're going to... we unlocked highways just now, didn't we? No, 2400. Oh, never mind. We're about to unlock highways. So I think I'm going to sort of build a little bit of our interchange here, and that's going to be how we end the video. We also unlocked parks. Parks, as you can see, people are not happy when they don't have parks. Just gonna build one here. I believe is this a modded park, or is this is a park that comes with the game. I have a lot of mods and a lot of user-generated content. I actually don't have any mods installed right now, but I have user content. For example, in our police here, we could build Wayne Tower, home of Bruce Wayne / Batman. And this is under police because it lowers crime rates suspiciously. Anything nearby has a lower crime rate. That's the sort of charm that people have in this game, the people who add content. And there's a really good user base for this game who makes amazing content. I don't know what I'm trying to say. There's some really good content out there, though. And we're just going to kind of build our high school. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's where we want it, right there. Get people educated. Okay, now we can build a highway. We just earned some money by reaching our next progress milestone. And so we're going to kind of begin our highway transformation. Right now, this is working pretty well, actually. But this won't last forever. So we're gonna try and... Now technically we should make this just a one-way... Well, I don't know. Not really, but... I don't know what I'm saying. I apologize. I'm very tired. So, people... This is a highway all the way into town. And what we're actually gonna do is build... And we're gonna do this from scratch just because it's what we probably need. Gonna build a highway interchange. Now this is our main road in town, so eventually we'll be upgrading this to 3 lanes in both directions. For now though, we're gonna get rid of most of it, and we destroyed a little bit more than I meant to. I think that's about how we want it, and we're going to make it highway for this section, for the section that we're going to have an interchange in. Go ahead and destroy this. And it's gonna be a little sloppy. Then about like that, I think is how we'll want it. And then extend this out like so. And we'll have to reconnect our power grid later. Actually, what we'll do for now, to be dramatic, is destroy this entire thing right here, and we'll connect it this from here to here later. That's gonna be one of the last things we do. So, now people can get from the main road in town, and they can just fly right through, go faster on the highway over here. Now this is ugly. You know what, I'm gonna be a little perfectionist about this. Since we're paused, we get most of our money back. When we destroy things right after building them. This isn't gonna look great, but it looks a little better now, and that should work a little better. So, and we're gonna come back here, and we're gonna build a bridge over. And for now, we're just gonna actually leave that Well, we'll build it a little further out. But we're going to leave it there because we don't have anything. The highway doesn't actually need to keep going this direction. And we're going to do the same thing over here. Now, technically, we are building this. The highway travels in the wrong direction the way we're building it right now. But if we right click all that, we can reverse the direction. So we need to have a total of 8 highway exits. And I've done this a lot, which is why I already know that it's 8 that we need. We need to be able to go, for example, from if we're traveling in this direction, we need to be able to go straight. We need to be able to turn right. We need to be able to go over here. And we need to be able to turn left. So we need to be able to get from here to there. So, left turns are the hardest part. And there are a couple different ways to do them. One, you could have, I mean, technically we can come underneath right here. We could go over, we could build a bridge this way. We could come around, we could pass it and then make this right turn like so, like that kind of. We'd make it prettier if we did that. And those are kind of the main left turn philosophies, I guess. Right turns are pretty simple. I mean, that's about as complex as we would get. We're going to worry first about all of our left turns. And actually, let's continue this out a little bit further just in case. I'm not exactly sure what I'm trying to do with this interchange yet, how big and crazy I want to make it, but we did leave plenty of room, which is, this is honestly the best I've ever done, leaving room for our main interchange into town. So this is probably about what our right turn will look like, but we're gonna work, like I say, we're gonna worry about left turns first. So I'm thinking that for the road that's in town, our main town road, we're gonna put our left turns in here, like this. So you come, if you're coming from this direction, you go under the highway and then you turn left like that. It's a little short of a ramp, but I think that's gonna work for us, work just fine. And we're gonna kinda copy the same thing over here. Let's see, we're having a few issues. Can we see, we might do something like that. We'll do it the way. So this game snaps a lot and we can actually turn off most of that, a lot of that here. But with this in this button down here, but we're not gonna do too much of that, I think. Okay, because of where this support is, it didn't like the way I wanted to build it. I do not like that. That is much too short. So we're gonna build just like that. I think that'll work for what we're trying to do here. And that'll, oh, I don't like how sharp that turn is. So you can get really anal, you can get really, come on, we want that there. There we go. So that's okay. So our from the main road onto the highway, we've got our 2 left turns there. Now we're gonna get a little fancy with our left turns into town. Now technically, I'm looking at the way our space is designated, and this is not the better way to do this. So we're gonna actually change that. Coming into town, underground. Coming into town is gonna be how we do this. And actually there is underground building now apparently, which was just added, I think. I don't have any experience with it. Which actually, that would be the better way to do this completely. Just, I'm thinking about it now. Should we just build a tunnel underground? Well, oh, that's really expensive though, isn't it? Oh, didn't mean to build that. See, that gets very expensive. Like, that's more expensive than bridges. Yeah, that's one level. That's very expensive. Yeah, so we're gonna build above ground for now. Okay, sorry. I'm learning new things about the game as we play. This video is getting very long also, but so actually, going into town from the highway is going to be how we use this space here. The space in the middle. Come on. So, and actually we could make just like an exit come here and then split off. We're going to come in like this and then do that. That's going to be how our into town exits work. All right, so we're going to build our left turns first. Sorry for bumping the microphones. Microphone. So we'll build like this. And that will be how that works. Now our left turns out of town. I'm going to build up and over. Now, I live in Texas, where we're partly famous for making everything much too large, including our interchange, because we love our cars. We as a whole, not necessarily me, much rather live with good public transportation, but anyway. So we're gonna come over here, and that's gonna be, can we build that? See, the reason this, we can't build that, I don't know if that'll work. That doesn't look too jagged. Sometimes you have issues if, for example, if you build something long and then the support in the middle ends up being on a road, but we'll delve more into that possibly at some point. I don't know. I'm fading very quickly, so I need to wrap this interchange up. We're gonna build essentially the same thing over this direction. Can we? What did we kind of came around and then like that and then crossed over the ramp. Is that what we did over here? Okay, we're not necessarily going for symmetry, but it's not gonna hurt. We just build that all in one fell swoop. So there can be quite a bit of trial and error in this. We could do that. No. Maybe, okay, and get rid of this section. Just try and make that work. It's not even going to be that pretty of an interchange. There we go. That works. That's okay. So that is all four of our left turns. Now we need our right turns. I'm going to say like this is how this right turn. Okay, so this slope here is too steep. So we're going to back it up a little bit so it doesn't have to be, and so that we can build a ramp coming off of it. So that's going to be our first right turn in that direction. We could do something like that with all of our, but that's going to require, the game can get finicky with, when you're building layers upon layers of interchange, and we'll just, actually, we could come out like that. We'll do the same thing over here. We'll do the same thing. We'll back this up enough to give us room to split off of this ramp. And we'll do that. That's not too bad. And just the two more turns. And we could do like that. I like the way that looks, but I don't like, because this means a lot of cars are gonna have to be using one ramp. Whereas these are pretty big ramps. They give us a lot of space, so it's okay for two different places to have one exit, if that makes any sense. And we'll kind of veer off like that. I want it to look the same, so. Well, I should probably redesign both of them. Like that. And our bridge, We'll do like this. There we go. Okay, so that is our interchange. Wow, I've been recording for 50-something minutes. Hopefully the video is more like 40-something minutes. At this point, I've edited down, trimmed some of the fat, but this is our first interchange, and we'll get the game going. We spent about $40,000. Oh, we never reconnected our power. We spent about $40,000 creating this interchange, and so hopefully it will serve us well in the future. It's a little bit overkill, honestly, at this point, but it should allow everybody from our industry to get out of town easily via this particular ramp that you see several cars using. It'll allow people to get across town from where they live to where they work, and it will also allow us to expand in this direction pretty seamlessly. So, just spend a minute here looking at it in action, making sure we didn't make any terrible mistakes. But I have a lot of experience making these sorts of interchanges. Actually, this is one of my favorites I've ever made. It looks pretty cool. We could go into the asset editor and try to make a symmetrical version of this. And actually, I'll just show off a few of the ones I've... these aren't mine, these are mods or user-generated content, all sorts of highways you can build. We don't have enough money to just build them, but all sorts of cool interchanges. These come with the game. These roundabouts. This is, I believe, that's the same. Yeah, those are the same. I can build that. So you don't have to build them from scratch every time. I just like to, especially to customize them for the space. Usually I'm working with even less space than this. And eventually we're going to adjust a lot of this. Like there's a mod that will let us prevent people from turning left here because that's going to be a problem eventually. There's a mod that allows you to do most everything. But and actually, I'm going to upgrade this to a three-lane road here, like so. And we'll do the same over here because that's going to give us a little more room for people to congregate. These are going to be traffic problems. A lot of traffic problems are potentially being set up right now. But that's going to wrap things up for this video. I'm sorry for taking so long. I'm sorry for taking so long to make another video. Hopefully there will be several more of this series. Hopefully there will be more of 7 days. No. Goodness, what is the game even called? This War of Mine. See, my brain is so fried right now that I just completely blanked on the name of one of my primary games on this channel and called it a completely different game that I've spent maybe 2 hours playing. I did back the Kickstarter for 7 Days to Die, though, so... gosh. Yeah, I'm going to go to bed. Thank you so much for watching, though. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. I really appreciate that. Please leave a comment if you have any questions, comments, or concerns. Next video should be a lot better. I don't anticipate recording it at... Oh, it is 3:30 in the morning. Oh, why am I awake? And subscribe to see future content. I noticed that I got a new subscriber while I wasn't posting anything, and if I remembered your name, dear subscriber, I would. If I remembered your username, I don't know your name, and hopefully don't want to know your name in real life. I don't. Anyway, that's a weird thing. Anyway, hopefully I've said enough to end this video, because I need to go to sleep. Thank you for watching, though, so much. I will talk more about this game and the channel and all sorts of stuff in other videos. Anyway, I'm gonna go to bed. Good night.